Tu devi continue o theoretic material. And begin with the topic surface integrals. Take your pen and begin surface integrals. Surface integrals. Let a region V be given in an x, y, z coordinate system. Let a surface sigma bounded by a certain space line lambda be given in region V. With respect to the surface sigma, we shall assume that at each point P of it the positive direction of the normal is determined by the unit vector n of P. The direction cosines of which are continuous functions of the coordinates of the surface points. At each point of the surface, let there be defined a vector f is defined by formula x of x, y, z times I plus y of x, y, z times j plus z of x, y, z times k, where x, y, z are continuous function of the coordinates.
Good morning.
Good morning. I think now it is day. Good day. Morning was written. Divide the surface in some way into subregion delta omega ice. In each subregion, take an arbitrary point P ice and consider the sum over I of vector f of P ice times vector n of P ice delta omega ice. Formula 1. Where vector f of e is the value of the vector f. At the point P is of the subregion delta omega is n of P is. Is the unit normal vector normal? It's R. At this point, and vector f times vector n is the scalar product of these vectors. Spin. The limit of the sum 1 extended over all subregion delta sigma is, as the diameters of all such subregions approaches zero, is called the surface integral and is denoted by the symbol double integral over sigma scalar product f times n with respect to sigma. Thus, by definition, this integral equals limit s diameter delta sigma is approaches zero of sum over I f is times n is scalar product delta sigma is. One more thing. Each term of the sum 1 may be interpreted mechanically as follows. This product is equal to the volume of a cylinder with base delta sigma is and altitude. Maybe I write down base delta sigma is and altitude f is times cosine of n is f is between these two vectors. If the vector f, this vector f, is the rate of flow of a liquid through the surface sigma, then product F I N I delta sigma ice equals F I delta sigma ice cosine between N ice and F ice, maybe three, is equal to the quantity of liquid flowing through the subregion delta omega ice in unit time in the direction of the vector n ice. Maybe I. Give you the picture right now. This. The expression double integral over sigma f n scalar product d sigma yield the total quantity of liquid flowing in unit time through the surface sigma in the positive direction if by the vector f we assume the flow rate vector of the liquid at the given point. Therefore, the surface integral to this integral is called the flux of the vector fired F through the surface sigma from the definition of a surface integral, it follows that if the surface sigma is divided into the part sigma first, sigma second, etc. to sigma case, then surface integral through the sigma of f n d sigma equals integral over sigma 1 plus integral over sigma second plus etc. plus integral over sigma case. Let us express the unit vector n in terms of its projections on the coordinate axis n equals cosine between n and x times I plus cosine between n and x and y times g plus cosine between n and z times k. Substituting in the integral 2 upon this integral. The expressions of the vectors f and n in terms of their projections we get integral over sigma f n d sigma equals integral over sigma of x capital X times cosine between n and x a little x plus y capital times cosine between n and y, a little y, plus z, capital Z, times cosine between n and z, a little z, d sigma, formula 2 prime. The product delta sigma times cosine between n and z is the projection of subregion delta sigma on the xy plane. If we consider this on the x, y, z coordinate system, we will have this delta sigma, projection of delta sigma of x 0 y is delta sigma x y, projection of z o y delta sigma y z, and projection on this plate delta sigma x z x z. An analogous assertion hold true for the following product as well. Delta sigma times cosine, cosine between n and x equals delta sigma y z. Delta sigma times cosine between n and y equals delta sigma x z, and delta sigma times cosine between n and z equals delta sigma xy. It is formulas for all of this. Formulas for. Where delta sigma yz, delta sigma xz, and delta sigma xy are the projection of the subregion delta sigma on the appropriate coordinate planes. On this basis, integral 2 prime, open 2 prime, can also be written in the form double integral over sigma f n d sigma equals integral over sigma of x times cosine of m x between n x plus y times cosine between n y plus z times cosine between n z d sigma equals double integral over sigma x dy dz plus y dz dx plus z dx dy. Formula 2 prime. Next subtitle, evaluating surface integrals. Evaluating surface integrals. Computing the integral over a curved surface reduces to evaluating a double integral over a plane region. To illustrate, the following is a method of computing the integral over sigma z cosine between n and z d sigma. Let the surface sigma be such that only any straight line parallel to the z-axis cuts it in one point. Then the equation of the surface may be written in the form that is f of xy. Denoting by d the projection on the surface sigma on the xy plane, we get by the definition of a surface integral, double integral over sigma of z of x, y, z times cosine between n and z d sigma equals limit s diameter delta sigma s approaches zero of sum I from 1 to n's z of x i's y i's z i's cosine between n i's and z delta sigma i's. It is sigma, that is sigma peak vector. Nothing further. The last of formula form. That we write here for therefore or this form. We obtain double integral over sigma z times cosine of n and z, here capital Z, z a little z, the sigma equals limit s diameter delta sigma x y approaches zero of sum where I change from 1 to n of z of x i's capital Z y i's f of x i's y i's delta sigma x I y i's equals plus or minus limit s diameter delta sigma approaches zero of sum I from 1 to n of z, here z capital Z, of x I y I f of x I y I modulus delta sigma x I ice. The last expression is the integral sum for a double integral of the function z of x, y, f of x y over the region D. Therefore, double integral over sigma z cosine between n and z d sigma equals plus or minus double integral over d z of x y f of x y dx dy. The plus sign in front of the double integral is taken if cosine of n z, this cosine, is greater or equal to zero. The minus sign if this cosine is less than or equal to zero. In the surface, sigma does not satisfy the condition indicated at the beginning of this section. Then it is divided into parts that satisfy this condition, and the integral is computed over each part separately. The following integral are computed in similar function, integral x cosine between n and x d sigma and integral capital Y times cosine between n and y d sigma. The foregoing proof justifies the notation of a surface integral in the form of 2 prime, this form. Here, the right side of 2 prime may be regarded as the sum of double integrals over the appropriate projection of the region sigma, and the signs of these double integrals, or otherwise states, the signs of the products dy times dz, dz times dx, and dx times dy are taken in accord with the foregoing rule. Consider the example, example 1. Let a closed surface sigma be such that any straight line parallel to the z-axis cuts it in no more than 2 points. Consider the integral over sigma z times cosine between n and z d sigma. We shall call the other normal the positive direction of the normal. In this case, the surface may be divided into two parts, lower and upper. Their equations are respectively z is f first of x, y, and z is f second of x, y. Denote by D the projection sigma of on the xy plane. Now I draw it. Double integral over sigma z times cosine between n and z d sigma equals double integral over d f secant of x y dx dy minus double integral over d f first of x y dx dy. The minus sign in the second integral is taken because in a surface integral the sign of dx dy on a surface z is f first of xy must be taken negative since for it cosine between n and z is negative. But the difference between the integrals on the right in the last formula yields a volume bounded by the surface sigma. This means that the volume of the solid bounded by the closed surface sigma is equal to the following integral over the surface. V is double integral over sigma z times cosine between n and z d sigma. Consider the example 2. A positive electric charge E, maybe I write down it, positive electric charge E placed at the coordinate origin creates a vector field such that at each point of space the vector F is defined by the Coulomb law S. Vector F is K times E over R squared modulus R times vector R, where R is is the distance on the given point from the origin. R, vector R, is the unit vector directed along the radius vector of the given point. Of the given point. And k is a constant coefficient. Determine the vector field flux through a sphere of radius r with center at the origin of coordinates. Determine the vector field flux through a sphere of radius r with the center at the origin of coordinates. Solution. Taking into account that R is capital R is constant, we will have double integral over sigma k times e times r over r squared scalar product r times n d sigma take the constant out our integral. Under integral, we have only scalar product and d sigma. But the last integral is equal to the area of the surface sigma. Indeed, by the definition of an integral, noting then scalar product Rn equals 1, we obtain integral over sigma Rn d sigma equals limit as delta sigma k approaches 0, sum of R chi n chi delta sigma chi all limit as delta sigma chi approaches 0, sum delta sigma k equals sigma. Hence, the flux is Ke over R squared times sigma, or Ke over R squared times 4 pi R squared, or 4 pi Ke. Next subtype, Stokes formula. Stokes formula. Let there be a surface sigma such that any straight line parallel to the z-axis cuts it in one point. Denote by lambda the boundary of the surface sigma. Take the positive direction of the normal n so that it forms an acute angle with the positive z-axis. This I show in this picture. Let the equation of the surface by z is f of x, y. The direction cosines of the normal are expressed by the formulas. This we can see later is formulas cosine between n and x is minus d f of dx over root of 1 plus df over dx squared plus df over dy squared. Root close. Cosine between n and y. Equals minus df over dy divided by same square root. And cosine between n and z same, but here 1. Because z is f. Yes, it is formulas 1 of this section. We shall assume that the surface sigma lies entirely in some region V. Let there be a function x of xyz given in V that is continuous together with first order partial derivatives. Consider the line integral along the curve lambda, integral along lambda of x, x, y, z, dx. On the line lambda, z is f of x, y, where x, y are the coordinates of the point of the line lambda, which is projection of the line lambda on the xy plane. Here, projection of lambda. This lambda, this projection. Thus, we can write the equation integral over lambda x of x, y, z, dx equals integral over L, x of x, y, f of x, y, dx, formula 2. The last integral is a line integral along L, a capital L. Transform this integral by Green's formula, putting x of x, y, f of x, y equals x with the upper line of x, y, and 0 equals y with the upper line of x, y. Substituting into Green's formula the expression of x with the upper line and y with the upper line, we obtain minus minus double integral over d, dx of xy, f of xy over dy, dx dy. Equals integral over L of x, y, f of x, y, dx, formula 3, where the region D is bounded by the line L. On the basis of the derivative of the composite function x of x, y, f of x, y, this function, where y enters both directly and in terms of the function z is f of x, y, we find dx of x, y, f of x, y over dy equals dx of x, y, z, with respect to y, plus dx of x, y, z with respect to z times df of x, y with respect to y. Formula 4. Substituting expression 4 into the left side of 3, we obtain minus double integral over d of dx of x, y, z with respect to y plus dx of x, y, z with respect to z times d f of x, y with respect to y, dx dy equals integral through L x of x, y, f of x, y, dx. Taking into account two, the last equation may be rewritten as integral over lambda of x, x, y, z, dx equals minus double integral over z of dx over dy, dx dy, minus double integral for d, dx of d over dz times df with respect to y times dx dy. Formula y. The last two integrals can be transformed into surface integrals. Indeed, from formula 2 to prime that we write down up this formula. It follows that it we have some function a with coordinate x, y, z, The following equation is true. Integral through sigma A x, y, z cosine between n and z. Maybe not vectors. D sigma equals double integral over d a dx dy. On the basis of this equation, the integrals of the right side of 5, this expression, are transformed as follows. Double integral over d, dx over dy, dx dy equals double integral over sigma dx over dy cosine of nz d sigma, double integral over d dx over dz df over dy dx dy equals double integral over sigma dx over dz times df over dy times cosine between n and z d sigma. It's formulas 6. Transform the last integral using formula 1 of this formula. These formulas. Dividing the second of these equations by the third term-wise, we find cosine between n and y over cosine between n and z equals minus df over dy. Or df over dy cosine between n and z equals minus cosine between n and y. Hence, double integral over d dx over dz times df over dy dx dy equals minus double integral over sigma dx over dz times cosine between n and y d sigma, formula 7. Substituting expression 6 and 7 into equation 5, 6 is this, and 7 is this, we get integral over lambda of x, y, z, dx equals minus double integral over sigma dx over dy times cosine between n and z d sigma plus integral over sigma dx over dz times cosine between n and y d sigma. 8. The direction of circulation of the contour lambda must agree with the chosen direction of the positive normal n. Normally, if an observer looks from the end of the normal, he sees the circulation along the curve lambda as being counterclockwise. Formula 8, this formula, holds true for any surface if this surface can be divided into parts whose equation have the form z is f of x, y. Similarly, we can write the formulas integral over lambda y of its letter y of x y z dy equals double integral over sigma of minus dy over z times cosine of between n and x plus dy over dx times cosine between n and z d sigma, maybe 8 prime, integral over lambda of z of x, y, z, dz equals double integral over sigma of minus dz over dx cosine between n and y plus dz over dy cosine between n and x d sigma 8 to prime. Adding the left and right side of 8 prime and 8 2 prime, we get the formula integral over lambda x dx plus y dy plus z dz equals double integral through sigma of dy over dx minus dx over dy times cosine between n and z plus dz, capital Z, over dy minus d capital Y over dz times cosine between n and x plus dx, x capital X, over dz minus dz capital over dx times cosine between n and y d sigma. This is formula 9. This formula is called Stokes formula. The formula 9 is called Stokes formula. Stokes' formula. After the English physicist and mathematician Stokes, his year of life from 1819 to 1903. In establishing a relationship between the integral over the surface sigma and the line integral along the boundary lambda on this surface, the circulation about the curve lambda being performed according to the same rule as the given earlier. The vector b defined by the projection b x is dz with respect y minus dy over dz b y is dx capital over dz minus dz over dx and b z is dy over dx minus dx over dy. Is called the curl or rotation of the vector function f is xi plus y g plus z k and is denoted by the symbol rot f. Thus, in vector notation, formula 9 will have the form integral over lambda f ds is integral over sigma n rotation f d sigma 9 prime. And Stokes' theorem is formulated thus. The circulation circulation of a vector around the contour of some surface Is equal to the flux of the curl through this surface. Through this surface. Note if the surface sigma is a piece of plane parallel to the xy plane, then delta z is zero and we get Green's formula as a special case of a Stokes formula. From formula 9 that we write down later, here formula, it follows that if dy over dx minus dx over dy equals 0, dz over dy minus dy over dz equals 0, dx over dz minus dz over dx equals 0, then the line integral along any closed space curve lambda is 0. Once it follows that the line integral is interdependent on the shape of the curve of integration. As the case of a plane curve, it may be shown that the indicated conditions are not only sufficient but also necessary. In the fulfillment of this condition, the expression under the integral sign is an exact differential of some function u with coordinate x, y, z. It means x dx plus y dy plus z dz equals du of x, y, z. And consequently, integral from Rm to n x dx plus y dy plus z dz equals integral from m to n du or u of n minus u of m. This is provided exactly like the corresponding formula for a function of two variables. What is our times? Not time. In this case, I must check you.